Welcome back to Landed Fishing. Today we're down in Hopedale, Louisiana. It is Mardi Gras time, Mardi Gras season. We're down here doing some fishing. It's a beautiful day, a little bit of breeze, but it's sheephead season. So sheephead are biting, and we hear they got some clean water. So we're gonna see if we can find some speckled trout, redfish, bull reds. It's just gonna be a great day. Instead of the parades, we chose to come out here and do some fishing in Hopedale. All right, so we're headed out this morning, and first thing I noticed is the water is super low. We got a southwest wind. If you could see, you can kind of see the mud bank showing. Probably not too good, but we got some super low water. So with a southwest wind and low water, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and towards the edges where I know there's some fish at in that square mile area, and I'm gonna fish the mouths of these ponds. I'm gonna find these big old openings in ponds with these shelves, because all these fish are gonna have to be outside of these ponds this morning. There's no way they can get back there. Water's not deep enough, so that's gonna consolidate the fish in front of the ponds. And as long as I still got a falling tide, which shows till about 4 o'clock, it's a 10 o'clock right now in the morning, then I'm going to go there. As soon as that tide starts coming up, they're gonna start trying to push back. They're gonna stage and start pushing back. But as long as it's falling, they're gonna sit on the outside. So hopefully my theory is correct. We pull up and we light these redfish up. I'm gonna go over what we're using today. So today I'm gonna throw a popping cork, 3/8 ounce popping cork, okay, cone shaped. Got a lot more cup to it for these redfish. And I'm only gonna run about an 18 inch piece of leader in these waters. It's real shallow, it's about a foot deep, like I said. We're fishing a pond where the mouth drops out as shallow as these fish can possibly get. Then it's hard bottom down here, which means oyster shells and stuff like that. So I'm only gonna run an 1/8 ounce jig head. If I run a quarter or 3/8, I'm gonna snag the bottom a lot more and end up getting hung up and breaking off a lot of rigs without catching fish. So that's what we're gonna run today. And let's see if we can get them. If they're here or not, it looks good, it looks right. Just gotta see if they're home.
I didn't see.
Oh, what is it? Saw that
pole
bent.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we don't want this.
What is it?
Oh, it's the old hardhead catfish.
Oh,
old hardhead.
So we made quite a few moves. No bites for a while. And finally, we finally hooked one up real quick. I think it's another big bull red. We're gonna find out. Way out there.
Mm-hmm. That's
a red.
Is it? Yeah. Might be that one.
Might be wrapped. Could be wrapped.
Huh?
He could be wrapped up, like body wrapped on it. Looks like he is a little bit.
Is that bad?
No, he's gotta be careful with the tension on the line. Could be in his gill or something. No, he's good. Nice fish too. Finally, huh?
Well, you caught two. I only caught one. My first one from
me. We gotta get them in first.
I know.
We gotta get them in.
I have to quit talking smack. Yeah.
Beautiful fish. Keep working this head up. It's a hammerhead. Really good one.
So at a certain point of the day, we kind of, it was slick calm out there. And when it gets slick calm, you got two options. One, you can go to a round cork, okay, and pop it very lightly and, you know, just kind of baby it, you know, and not, because the fish will get a little spooky when it gets slick calm. The other option you have is to tie a 30-pound fluorocarbon leader on, okay, about a 2-foot piece, and then tie you a jig head on the end, okay, either a quarter or 1/8-ounce jig head, whatever you need to get the cast out there and not get snagged up. Now, you're going to need hard bottom for this. You can't do this on a real soft, grassy bottom. If you got shells or sand or anything, you're going to hook your dead shrimp on there, throw it out there, and let it sit. And let those fish come pick it up, okay? Because when it gets slick calm, that hard pop into the cork, a lot of times those fish are going to get scared, and they're going to spook on that. As to where if you throw out a jig head with a shrimp, it's a soft splash, and they'll come pick it up. So hopefully when you get into that glass situation, this helps you catch more redfish. Oh, it took about 2 or 3 casts, and we hooked up on them. Nice slot fish.
Do you need the...
fish, but he's hot too. Really pretty redfish. A little bigger than we're looking for. We're looking for some slot eating fish, but we're not complaining. Nice healthy fish. Came up right behind a cork, took a look at it, and smoked it. Let's see if we find a couple more up on this flat. See you, buddy. So, wasn't what we hoped for today. Caught, I don't know, 5-6 bull reds, 1 or 2 trout. Sheephead or 2, I think we got off, and a couple catfish actually, which is, no, it's starting to be springtime. We're starting to see those. Not every day is going to be perfect. You know, the fish I thought would be there were gone. They were winter fish in the area I'm in. You know, these fish are in a square mile area, and they're gone. And the bull reds just weren't really biting, and the sheephead just weren't there either. So, hey, any day on the water is a good day compared to being on land. So we'll take it. We weren't skunked, caught some fish, had some fun, and hopefully y'all learned a couple things. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel. We appreciate all the support, and keep following. More videos to come.